Hi guys, welcome to Delores Studios. We'll be revisiting the Firebase phone authentication system. This time we're going to be giving a professional touch to the phone MP3 feed, where we're going to be introducing the country code picker library. This is an Android library that provides an easy way to search and select country or country phone code for the telephone number. This is actually going to give a better UI interface where user don't have to type in the country codes, like probably if you're from USA plus 1, if you're from India plus 91, and if you're from Nigeria plus 234, you don't have to type that, and you're going to have a more intuitive UI where you need to just select your particular phone code based on the country, and you could also search, and that is actually done on the fly. So I'm going to be introducing that right into the application, where we're going to have a smooth, intuitive, and smooth running UI. So without much ado, I'll be heading straight to Android Studio, where I have the source code, and I will implore you to follow along with me. It's very, very simple to achieve. Head straight down to the build gradle, where you have your dependencies. You will need to include the com.hbbb20, that's the CCP, that's the code picker, the country code picker, 2.1.9, that's the version at the point of recording. You use the implementation if you're using the previous Android Gradle, you could use Compound. But once you have that set up in the dependencies, you're good to go. You synchronize Gradle and you set your application ready to implement some of the methods right in the country code picker. Looking at the activity main, which is the major focus where you have the form. Let me quickly expand this so you could visualize what you expect in here. Look at the phone number session. You have the country code right beside the phone input. So once you just click on that, you could select on the particular country dialing code you are trying to send the OTP verification to. So if you're using the US, you can see plus one with the flag, which actually depicts the country you're selecting. So that's actually very, very professional to use. So let's cover the other aspect of the implementation. You have the setup right there in the relative layout, where you have the text view of the status, which will actually tell you if you sign out or not. That's not the full focus. In the relative layout, which is right inside the relative layout, where you have the phone art as the ID, this wraps around the phone number, the picker, and the edit text. So pay more attention to this aspect. You have the linear layout afterwards, so that you could have elements side by side, one after each other. You have the text view that follows that says the phone number, which is just like a label to tell you what that particular session does. And another linear layout wrapped around, and this actually is where you have the country code picker tag, which you have right there, the country code picker. And you have you could actually select a default name code that's actually going to be the default picker or the default dialing code that will be showed anytime you're launching the UI. We selected US if you're selecting India, if you're selecting Nigeria, if you're selecting Sweden, so you just need to know the two short codes, which is like the abbreviation of the country, and from that it's actually going to populate the default name code. And that's what you have right there. So you have it right there in the linear layout, and the edit text is right after, and it's actually floating by the side of the country picker. So yeah, I will implore you to actually style your layout just exactly as what you're seeing here. So don't have a displaced layout. Probably your code picker is floating somewhere, and the edit text, which will actually take in the phone number, is also floating elsewhere. The coherence won't actually flow, and you might have problem when you're trying to actually generate or extract the number from the edit text. So you have the ID as a phone text and the int called phone, and the input type is the phone, and there you have it as a single line through, so that it doesn't jump down to the next line. So you just have a single line of an edit value. So that does that, and you wrap that around the linear layout with the external linear layout wrapped around a relative layout. So with this display, you could have that bunch of implementations. You can see the phone number is right fixed, and it's actually going to display very well in any phone screen sizes. So that's just how to achieve this. So let's move ahead. We should know other aspects of the snippet. We have the send button, which is actually going to send the phone number and down to the Firebase server, where you're going to actually get the verification code, and which will verify the validity of the number. Normally it does that automatically if your app is running. Now if the phone number you're using is actually the app running, so that's actually going to be done automatically, just like when you have WhatsApp phone verification and some other application verification. But if you're using probably the number you're actually locked in as the phone number to verify is not where the app is running, you will need to get the manual code from the number sent as a SMS, and you will need to pass it down to the verify session. So that's when you need the verify session. So in any situation whereby you need to resend the code, probably due to internet connectivity failure, so you could actually resend that code. Probably you've been expecting it for long and you're not seeing it, so you could trigger the resend button. So that's what that's going to do over here, the reset button. And this edit text is taking the code which was sent to not the number which is not running on the app. So that's what you have here. You need to type in the code, get it from the SMS, and you trigger the button to verify button over here. So that's actually going to verify the code for you. We'll be looking at the methods that's actually handling all this trigger right there in the classes. And without much wasting of time, you head straight to the activity messaging. This is actually just going to hold on to the next activity, because we want to actually make a flow from the authentication system. Once successfully authenticated, you are headed straight to the next activity. That's an intent with trigger to call the next activity. So you have that to support the next activity called activity messaging XML. So it's actually going to say a welcome to this application, and it's going to spit out your phone number for you to know that this actually work correctly. And the Java classes still maintain two activities, the main activity and the messaging activity. Messaging activity is tied to the activity messaging XML, while the main activity is tied to the activity main, which you could get the phone authentication done. Full focus will be on the main activity. Let's get to look at that closely. We start from the beginning. A main activity that extends App Compact. You have the fields here, the edit text, the tool edit text for the phone text and the code when you're trying to type in the code. You have the buttons, the verify, the send, the resend, the sign out, and the text view of the status. And we have the number, a string variable that will actually hold on to the number when you're actually generating it from the code picker library. We'll get to look at all that. The phone verification ID, the phone auth provider. You need that very, very importantly. You need to add that in the dependencies, and the force resend token when you're trying to resend the token. That's a message that the four codes that you're trying to use in verifying the phone number. And you have the Firebase auth and the code picker, the country code picker object. You need that very well too. So let's get to see how you're going to interact with all these elements I mentioned. In the activity main, you initialize the fields, the phone text, the code text, you call there its appropriate IDs down to these fields, so that they will be usable. And you also have for the code picker, you initialize, and at the point of the code picker, you have the object which is going to call on register carrier number edit text, the carrier, the number edit text. So it's tying down to the edit text So what are you passing as a parameter here? The edit text, the phone text. That's the field of the phone, where you get to type your phone, the phone number text, the real phone number. So it's actually tying that to the code picker. So you could have it tied that using the method register the carrier number edit text. So you have that set up. You set enable to false at the point of launch, the verify button, the resend button, the sign out button. So you have that, and you instantiate the Firebase auth calling the instance, so that object will be usable. Now let's get to look at all the methods needed. In the send code method, you need to get the call the object of the CCP, which is the country code picker. You get full number with plus, with a plus sign now, because you're not leaving the country code out of this, because you actually need a country code to send the right OTP message to the phone number, or as SMS to the phone number. So it's very, very important. That's why you need to get full number with plus, and you pass that to the string number. Cool. After that, that's where you send the code now. You could also do some validation so that the number must not be empty or must not be null. So at that point in time, you verify that. So if it's null or if it's empty, you tell the user, please make sure you type into the input field of the phone edit text. So that's just some little verification there. After that, you set up verification callbacks, and that's the method that runs underneath here. This method actually instantiates the phone auth provider. So that's the library we use it, not the email, not the email and password, as we know, not the GitHub, not the Facebook, not the Twitter. We are using the phone authentication provider, which is actually from Firebase. And you call on the on verification state change callbacks, and that override two methods, the on verification completed and the on verification failed. And you have that, and even on code sent, you have three methods of reading: the on verification failed, on code sent, and on verification completed. Let's get to look at them one after the other. On verification completed, you pass in the phone auth credential objects. That's where you get to set enable to the sign out. You get to set the text, probably you sign it in, and you get to set the resend button to be false, because you're actually taking an action here. Your verify button should be false. Let this get completed before all those get active, so that you won't start to send multiple calls to the server for process. And you get to trigger the sign in with phone auth credential method. So that's the method that will be triggered during this. You can see the way they are actually intermingled together. And you have that string triggering this method, and it passes the credential object. And from there, you move further. And this way, you could actually relate with the Firebase system. You call the FB auth again here to sign in with the credential you have, and you add on complete listener to this method, and this override when you share the class, and this override the uncomplete method. So that's when the you actually check if this is done is completed, and we do that when you pass, you call the tax. If it's successful, if it's successfully done, that's when you'll be very sure that yes, you've actually completed this. That's in an automatic way. That's after the process has been finished. And this is where you get to set up or try to enable some other interaction, like the sign out, and the verify can still be false, and because the resend to can still be false, because this is completed. You've actually hit the kernel of the server, and the server have sent the code, and the code has been verified. That's it. When it's been completed, when it's been verified, and at this point in time, you could use the Firebase user object to interact, to get the metadata of the user, get the phone number, get the UID, get the name, get some other details, get email of that particular user, which is actually saved in the Firebase console. That's why I could use the Firebase user to get the phone number. You get the results, you get the user, and you get the phone number. This is when the process is completed successfully. And you could trigger an intent after that to the message activity And you could also give a toast that, oh, wow, you've actually authenticated successfully. You could move on with the application or something like that. And you should also catch an exception. The Firebase auth invalid credential exception. So this is when the verification code enter was invalid. That's when you're actually doing that manually. You can catch this exception that no, the verification code you actually locked in here is invalid or not successful. The whole process is not successful. You catch an exception here. That is if the process actually went through as needed. Now let's get to look at other aspects. If it failed over here, you could actually trigger a message as well. That's where you catch an instance of the Firebase auth invalid credentials exception or an instance of the Firebase too many request exception. You've actually loaded the SMS code, that you've passed the quota, exceeded it. So that's some other instance that you could actually catch so that the user could know what they're actually doing wrong. So that's very, very useful. Now let's get to see if the code is being sent sent manually, and you want to actually get that done. So you still need the verification ID. You need to resend the token. Now you want to send the token and you create the verification button. You made it true, and the resend button as well, you made that true. So you will look at the verify code. In the verify code, now you're going to actually pick the details of the code, because you need to type the code manually to the details and trigger the words, the verify code button. So that's the button here, and what it's going to do is still going to call on the sign in with phone authentication credential I mentioned. They actually go through the process until it's being completed, and it's going to pass in the phone verification ID and the code itself, which is the string, the phone number, alongside to the sign in with phone auth credential method. So that's this method is very, very important. This is the core of the application that's actually going to send the code and listen to the callback if it's successful or if it's completed or not, and also catch different instances of an exception that could trigger from the process. So with that, you have the resend code here. When you are trying to resend the code, probably something up with the internet connection. When you send the code, the internet break up, and you need to trigger the resend code. Now you still need to use the CCP, the country code picker object, to get the phone number with plus. You pass that to the number string, and you set up verification callbacks. We have that discussed. The verification callback is seen here. That actually get to know the instance and do some other things before sending down to the signing with phone auth credential. So that's just the process. It will stay passed through that process. And what you're going to do, you have the phone auth provider, you get the instance, you verify the phone number. These are the parameters you will need: the phone number, the milliseconds, or let's say the seconds that you really want to you will send this, which you could actually put 60 seconds, and you have the time unit, is in seconds, is in minutes. So you specify seconds, the activity, the callback. You need a callback and the resend token. Those are the parameters you'll be passing when you are trying to resend the code to a particular phone number. So that's cool. So those are just the process. You need to resend code if you need to resend code, if you need to verify code, and if you need to send the code. The send code will actually pass through the normal process. The same way to actually go through the verify code. But at the same time, you will need to catch some exception. Probably you've exceeded the SMS quota, or you have an invalid credential, or something happened and it actually broke up. So you need to also catch all those instances. Let's get to look at the manifest. In the manifest, you need to log in the activity you are going to use, which is the messaging activity. Very, very important. So that's actually going to undo the successful process. So let's get to look at the message activity quickly. This activity is expecting an intent, which is the phone number, because we actually passed that from the main activity from the successful process over here, when we actually interacted with a Firebase user over here, when you call the intent, we pass in an extra, which is the phone number, the value over here, that was gotten from the phone number of that particular user. So you could actually pass as an extra. You could pass the name, if there is a name in the console saved, if there is an address saved for the user, if there is the email saved for the user, you could actually also get that at this point in time. So you pass that as an extra. So that is when you could actually move away from this process and use an intent to actually do it. And the point of doing that is when it's successful. In this point, when the task is successful, that's the only point you need to say, this, everything is completed, move to another activity with a successful message. That's very, very explicit enough. So that's what that is passing down to the message activity, and the message activity is expecting an extra and also saving that to a string, and you could use that value, the phone number. You can even save to shared preference. You could use it as you feel like. So in this scenario, we're just setting that to the text, which is the text view of the layout activity messaging, just telling that this is the authenticated phone number and passing the value of the phone number. So with that, we've actually completed the session, and I'll reply you to layout on the GitHub code, which I'll be sharing to in the repositories right there. And we say, if you have any query or if you have any problem with this implementation, leave a message in the message session of this video, and I'll make it short. I'll be there to actually attend to any of your problem when it comes to this integration, and even in any Android implementation in general. So all the same, I would say, please always subscribe to the channel if you're hitting this video for the first time. If you're not subscribed to the channel, please do. You will be losing a lot, or you'll be missing out from a lot of things if you are not subscribing, because there is a lot and lot and lot coming up in stock for your learning, and it's actually for your delight. Thank you very, very much for hanging out with me throughout this video, and have a pleasant time. Stay blessed.